it's hot out there. If anyone needs a nurse... Just kidding. Yeah, just plugging myself, huh? No shame. No shame at all. In 1968, you weren't even allowed to wear t-shirts to school. By 1980, Ted himself took liberties with the dress code. Here to entertain us are Nancy Monitor, Nancy Smith, and Julie Schrader.
This stops out. Till they call the cops out. Watch your behind till you're bad. But you gotta have a gimmick if you wanna get ahead. Hey, you can sacrifice your sacrum, waking in the back room, falling in a dump till you're bad. Girl, you gotta have a gimmick if you wanna get ahead.
Do it with a switch. Now,
who says I don't teach marketable skills?
Yeah, there goes our PG-13. Okay, also from Gypsy, please welcome Mindy Gerwood.
I had a dream about you, baby. It's gonna come true, baby. They think that we're through, but baby, you'll be swell, you'll be great. Gonna have the whole world on a plate, starting here, starting now. Honey, everything's coming up roses. Clear the decks, clear the tracks. You've got nothing to do but relax. Blow a kiss, take a bow. Honey, everything's coming up roses. Now's your innings. Stand the world on its ear. Set it. Great, I can tell, just you wait. That lucky star I told about is due. Honey, everything's coming up roses for me and for you. You can do it. All you need is a hand. We there's the bell, follow me, and nothing's gonna stop us till we're through. Honey, everything's coming up roses and daffodils. Everything's coming up sunshine and lollipops. Everything's gonna be bright lights and lollipops.
The year is 1964, a great year in America. The Beatles arrived, Ford Mustang, first year, and I was born. Ma, stop the crying there, I know you get wisty there. Ted's first big production, The Music Man. The very first line of that show was delivered by a younger, somewhat lighter incumbent to the throne, Roy Nelson. Harold Hill was played by Ron Brambley, who's still hanging around this very theater. Please welcome back these two more seasoned veterans.
Board, all aboard. River City Junction, River City, next station stop.
Friends, listen. Now, either you're closing your eyes to a situation you don't wish to acknowledge, or you are not aware of the caliber of disaster indicated by the presence of a pool table in your community. Well, now you got trouble, my friends. Right here, I say trouble, right here in River City. Why, sure, I'm a billiard player, certainly mighty proud to say, I'm always mighty proud to say it. I consider that the hours I spend with a cue in my hand are golden. Help you cultivate horse sense and a cool head and a keen eye. Did you ever take a try to give an ironclad leave to yourself from a three-rail billiard shot? But just as I say, it takes judgment, brains, and maturity to score in a ball-flying game, I see that any boob can take and shove a ball in a pocket. And I call that sloth. The first big step on the road to the depths of degradation. I say first, medicinal wine from a teaspoon, then beer from a bottle. And the next thing you know, your son is playing for money in a pinchback suit and listening to some big out-of-town jasper. He didn't tell about horse race gambling. Not a wholesome trotting race, no, but a race where they sit down right on the horse. Like to see some stuck-up jockey boy setting on Dan Patch. Make your blood boil, well, I should say. Now, friends, let me tell you what I mean. You got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 pockets in the table. Pockets that mark the difference between a gentleman and a bum with a capital B, and that rhymes with P, that stands for pool. And all week long, you ever see the youth will be frittering away, say your young men will be frittering. Frittering away their noontime, supper time, chore time too. Get the ball in the pocket. Never mind getting the dandelions pulled with a screen door patched with a beefsteak pounder. Never mind pumping any water till your parents are caught with a cistern empty on a Saturday night, and that's trouble. Yeah, you got lots and lots of trouble. I'm thinking of the kids in the knickerbocker, shirt tail young ones, peeking in the pool hall window after school. You got trouble, folks, right here in River City. Trouble with a capital T, and that rhymes with P, and that stands for pool. Now, I know all you folks are the right kind of parents. I'm going to be perfectly frank. Would you like to know what kind of conversation goes on while they're loafing around that hall? They'll be trying out Bebo, trying out Q-Grabs, trying out TaylorMade's like cigarette fiends, and bragging all about how they're going to cover up a telltale breath with scents in one fine night. They leave the pool hall heading for the dance at the Armory. Libertine men and scarlet women and ragtime. Shameless means that'll grab your son, your daughter, into the arms of a jungle animal instinct. Masteria! Frenzy, idle brain is the devil's playground. Trouble! Right here in River City.
Right here in
the
city.
With a capital T, and that rhymes with P, and that stands for pool.
That stands for
pool. We surely got trouble.
We surely got trouble.
Right here in River City.
Right here.
Gotta figure out a way to keep the young ones moral after school.
Our children's gonna have trouble.
Mothers of River City, heed that warning before it's too late. Watch for the telltale signs of corruption. The minute your son leaves the house, does he rebuckle his knickerbockers below the knee? Is there a nicotine stain on his index finger, a dime novel hidden in the corn crib? Is he starting to memorize jokes from Cap'n Billy's whiz bang? Are certain words creeping into his conversation? Words like swell. Ah, and so's your old man. Well, so my friends, you got trouble. Right here in River City. With a capital T, and that rhymes with P, and that stands for pool. We surely got trouble. Right here in River City. Remember the Maine, Plymouth Rock, and the Golden Rule. Oh, we got trouble. We're in terrible, terrible trouble. That game with the 15 numbered balls is the devil's tool. Oh yeah, you got trouble, trouble, trouble.
We have trouble here,
we
got big, big trouble.
With a T, not around with P, and that stands for pool. Remember, my friends, listen to me because I passed this way but once.
Ted thought that his troubles were actually over when Ron graduated, but no. Here to join him is his lovely daughter, Dana.
Water and 10 cornets made the air. Then I modestly took my place as a one and only bass. And I umpired up and down the square.
Good night, my someone. Good night, my love.
With 110 cornets right behind.
Our star is shining its brightest light.
There were horns of every shape and kind. Sweet dreams be yours, dear, if dreams there be.
While 110 cornets play the air,
I wish I may, and I wish I might.
Now good night, my someone. Good night.
There won't be a dry seat in the house.
Certainly not tonight either, huh? In 1978, Ted staged Hans Christian Andersen. And in that production, he saw over the head of, but not to overlook the talent of, a young lady who has gone on to become a contemporary Christian recording artist. Please welcome the very lovely and very short Lori Cartledge.
His arms were warm as they welcomed me. His eyes were fire bright. And then I knew what my path must be through the ever-haunted night. For anywhere I wander, anywhere I roam, till I'm in the arms of my darling again, my heart will find no home. Anywhere I wander, anywhere I roam, his arms were warm as they welcomed me. His eyes were fire bright. And then I knew what my path must be through the ever-haunted night. For anywhere I wander, anywhere I roam, till I'm in the arms of my darling again, my heart will find no home. Anywhere I wander, and anywhere I roam.
Why, a thing of beauty is a joy forever.
Ted, not content to deal with raging hormones of high school students in high school only, took on summer stock, as he has every year, to look through the flock, see what sort of talents are blossoming for the future high school productions. It was the summer of 1968, and Claudia Peluso Perry was Annie Oakley. Claudia has continued to work as a professional performer, including the second female lead in the movie The Brinks Job with Peter Falk and Jenna Rollins. Her Frank Butler, who else? Jack McGrady.
The cowboys, the tumblers, the wrestlers, the clowns, the roustabouts that move the show at dawn.
The music, the spotlights, the people, the towns, your baggage with the labels pasted on.
The sawdust and the horses and the smell.
The towel you've taken from the last hotel. There's no business like show. Like no business I know.
Everything about it is appealing. Everything the traffic will allow.
Nowhere do you get that happy feeling when you are stealing that extra bow.
There's no people like show. They smile and low.
The audience that lifts you when you're down.
The headaches, the heartaches, the backaches, the flops,
the sheriff who escorts you out of town.
The opening when your heart beats like a drum.
The closing when the customers don't come. There's no business like show, business like no business I know.
You get word before the show has started that your favorite uncle died at dawn.
Top of that, your ma and pa have parted. You're brokenhearted, but you go on.
Understudy! There's no people like show, people they don't run out of dough.
Angels come from everywhere with lots of jack, and when you need it, there's no attack.
Where could you get money that you don't give back? Let's go on with the show.
There's no business like show business if Ted tells us it's so.
Ted said doing theater would be thrilling.
Looking for a job both day and night.
10 years doing cats like getting filling.
Ted, where's our billing and where's our light?
There's no people like show. People, they smile when they are low. Even with a turkey that you know will fall, you may be stranded out in the cold. Change it for a sack of gold. Let's go on with the show. Let's go on with the show.
Why, I haven't seen legs like those since we sold the piano.
I'm engaged. Ted knew a good thing when he saw it. In 1969, the senior play was Little Me. The lead that year was Rob Evans. In 1975, Rob's little brother, Craig, reprised the very same leading role in the school musical.
Excuse, I will be right back with you.
Toi.
Ta-da!
Thank you.
Or, as we say in your language,
thank you.
I am Jean Valjean.
No, you're not.
Wait a minute, Jean Valjean.
No.
That's a rather play.
French,
but not just French. It's Les Miserables.
This may be Miserable, but...
Actually, so one where they go. No, wait. I will try it again.
Good luck. Wish
him
luck.
Thank you very much. I may need it. I am Val Duval.
And I am Val Duval.
The great French nightclub entertainer. Entertainers.
Merci. We would like to do for you a song about the love.
Oh, but not the little bitty love that goes plinkety-plink-plink-plink.
No. But the great bigger French love that goes boom, boom, boom. Our famous a boom boom song.
Poupereau, I hear him yet in pursuit of his Pierrette, who is the same old urgent message to impart. What it was, he never found out, for the point was always drowned out by the violent cannonading of his heart.
Boom, boom.
He'd say, Pierrette, and clear his throat.
What?
I'm very sorry, it's my brother.
A spittle is a piano player. What can I do, eh? And to clear his throat. Not just lest that. We forget.
And here I quote. If the girl boom, boom, and the boy boom, boom, and they get together and they both boom, boom, say la grande boom, boom, and la grande boom, boom, that's the one boom, boom for me. Oh, a stray boom, boom.
Oh, care to know the day, boom, boom, and carry you away. But the prime, boom, boom, that's sublime, boom, boom. Won't be true, not if you, all the time, boom, boom.
What I mean is my sherry. Save the grand, boom, boom, for me. If a man, boom, boom, and the wife, boom, boom,
so it's just legalized for life.
Boom, boom, c'est la grande, boom, boom, et la grande, boom, boom, that's the one, boom, boom, for me. Have a wee, boom, boom, and I will turn a hair.
Un petit, boom, 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 avec la secrétaire.
Only plan, boom, boom, if you can, boom, boom, not the tired, uninspired businessman, boom, boom. So I beg on bended knee, save the grand boom, boom, for me. Ah, but that was long ago.
Oh,
are you okay?
I'm okay, okay.
They are married now, and so every night Perrault climbs wearily to bed. And Perrault becomes a martyr, climbs upon the vocal starter, and the only thing's the pounding of his head.
Boom, 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 boom.
She says, Perrault, he only snores. The rest you know. She says once more, if the girl boom boom and the boy boom boom and they get together and they both boom boom c'est la grande boom boom et la grande boom boom, that's the one boom boom for me. Not the chic boom boom that happens on the sly.
No, the meek boom boom, or content with no reply.
But the dream boom boom, that's supreme boom boom, is for two people who like a team boom boom. What I mean is my sherry. Say the grand boom boom for me.
I brought that one up in the shower this morning.
You think any of those girls needs a nurse? Just kidding, just kidding. Last year, 1992, Ted took us back to a different era and a different country. Please welcome Kelly Gensimer and Josh Reif.
Life's an empty thing. Life can be so awful lonesome if you're always on your own song. Life's an empty thing.
Life's a different thing when you found your one and only. Then you feel no longer lonely. Life's a happy thing.
Everything was topsy-turvy, life seemed all wrong. Then it came all right as soon as you came along. Me and my girl, meant for each other, sent for each other, and liking it so. Me and my girl, it's no use pretending. We knew the ending a long time ago. some little church with a big steeple. Just a few people that both of us know, and we'll have love, laughter, be happy ever after. Me and my girl.
I love to hear you saying me and my girl. Meant for each other, sent for each other. I'm liking it so. Me and my girl, it's no use pretending. We knew the ending a long time ago. Some little church with a big steeple.
Just a few people that both of us know. And we'll have love, laughter, be happy ever after. Me and my girl.
In Shakespeare's The Taming of the Shrew, we met yet another strong-willed leading lady. In the musical version of that play, Kiss Me, Kate, the strong-willed leading lady had a strong effect on her paramour, Mr. Rob Marion.
I wrote a poem in classic style. I wrote it with my tongue in my cheek and my lips in a smile. But of late my poem has a meaning so new. For to my surprise, it suddenly applies to my darling, to you. Were thine that special face, the face that fills my dreaming. Were thine the rhythm, grace. Were thine the form so lithe and slender. Were thine the art so warm, so tender. Were thine the kiss divine. Were thine for me, the love that fills my dreaming. When all these charms are gone, then you'll be mine, all mine.
If anyone was the teacher's pet, it had to be Craig Evans. Yeah, boo, Craig Evans. He did 10 shows with Ted. Luckily, he has the time, and since it's so cool, he's gonna do every number from all 10 shows. No, we're simply gonna let him do one more. And in this one, he'll be accompanied by Angela Ferriero in a song from the musical Godspell.
And the land sinks into
mellow blueness, oh please take me with you. Let me skip the road with you.
I can dare myself.
I'll put a pebble in my shoe
and watch me walk.
I can walk.
I shall call the pebble dare.
We'll talk together about walking. Dare shall be carried. And when we both have had enough, I will take him from my shoes, singing, meet your new road.
Then I'll take your hand. Finally glad
that you are here.
By my side.
That you are here
by my
love, the essence of American musical theater. Whether it's love for people, places, or things, love is generally the theme around which the plot usually spins. It's my pleasure to introduce my very own sister Marilyn Flanagan, and for you all tonight, a rare treat, as you will be inside Marilyn's mind and witness the very actions that she had to put up with while rehearsing every show she ever did.
My day in the hills has come to an end, I know.
Ma, do we gotta hear this every night?
A star has come out to tell me it's time to go. But deep in the dark green shadows, a voice says that urge me to stay. So I pause and I wait and I listen for one more sound, for one more lovely thing that the hills might say. Like the wings of the bird that fly from the lake to the trees. My heart wants to sigh like a chime that flies from a church on a breeze. To laugh like a brook when it trips and falls over stones on its way. To sing through the night like a lark who is learning to pray. I go to the hills. what I've heard before. My heart will be blessed with the sound of music, and I'll sing once more. Thank you, sir.
She's not gonna sing once more for real, right? Sorry, I got disconnected. Few musicals in our history of American theater have moved our souls as much as Fiddler on the Roof. In 1973, Ted was again blessed with a talented group of students. Hollywood had Topol, but Ted had the Girdwood sisters, Jody, Ricky, and Mindy. And John Moss, who has gone on to work steadily and as a professional actor on both stage and television, welcome them to our stage.
Matchmaker, make me a match. Find me a find, catch me a catch. Matchmaker, look through your book and make me a pearl. I bring the veil, you bring the groom, slender and pale. Bring me a ring, for I'm longing to be the envy of all I see. My papa, make him a scum. For my mama, make him rich as a king. For me, well, I wouldn't holler if he were as handsome as anything.
Matchmaker, make me a match. Find me a find, catch me a catch. Night after night I'm a dog come along, so find me a match of my own.
Since when are you interested in a match, Mindy?
I thought you only had your eye on your book.
I thought you only had your eye on the rabbi's son.
Well, why not? We only have one rabbi and he only has one son. Why shouldn't I want the best?
Because you're a girl from a poor family and whatever you have the rich will think, right?
Of course,
that's right.
That's right.
Huddle, have I made a match for you? He's handsome, he's young, all right, he's 62, but he's a nice man, a good catch, right? Right, I promise you'll be happy, and even if you're not, there's more to life than that. Don't ask me what.
Papa, I found him!
Will you be a lucky bride? He's handsome, he's tall, that is from side to side, but he's a nice man, a good catch, right? Right, you heard me, had a temper, he'll beat you every night, but only when he's sober, so you're all right. Did you think you'd get a prince?
Well, I do the best I can. With no money, no dowry, no family background. Be glad we've got a man.
Matchmaker, make me a match. You know that I'm still very young. Up till this minute I misunderstood that I could get stuff for good.
Dear Yanto, see that he's gentle. Remember you are also a friend.
It's not that I'm sentimental. It's just that I'm terrified.
Thicker matchmaker, plan me no plans. I'm in no rush. Maybe I've learned playing with matches a girl can.
this the little girl I carry? Is this the little boy at play?
I don't remember growing older. When did they?
When did she get to be a beauty? When did he grow to be this tall?
Wasn't it yesterday when they were small?
Sunrise, sunset, sunrise, sunset, swiftly flow the days. Seedlings turn overnight to sunflowers, blossoming even as we gaze. Sunrise, sunset, swiftly fly the years.
One season following another,
laden with happiness and tears.
Now is the little boy a bridegroom? Now is the little girl a bride?
Under the canopy I see them side by side.
Place the gold ring around her finger, share the sweet wine and break the glass.
Soon the full circle will have come to pass.
Sunset, swiftly flow the days. Seedlings turn overnight to sunflowers, blossoming even as we gaze. Sunrise, sunset, swiftly fly.
Kloos has touched the lives of many people with the magic of theater. He's taught us a lot about the idea of inspiration. Some of those people who were chosen by Ted to walk the boards here have gone on to soar. Our next performer is one of Broadway's brightest rising stars and a personal favorite of mine, because when I finished my show here, my first work ever in the theater, he walked right up to me. And in a very special way, he looked me in the eye and he said, "You're very good. Don't quit." And it meant a lot, and it inspired me. So it's a special honor for me to introduce, direct from New York, and his starring role in the current Broadway hit of Miss Saigon, Mr. Herman Shebeck.
Thank you. Ted, when I got to do leading player in Pippin here on this stage, everyone told me I'd be going to Broadway. And, well, a year later, after doing my first semi-professional job, which you gave me, doing Pippin at the Open Air Theater in Washington Crossing, I got the Broadway revival of West Side Story with Debbie Allen. That was a beginning of many experiences that showed me that the opportunities and the support I got from the Neshaminy and the Bucks County area had instilled in me a very powerful belief. And that is the belief that doing what you really love to do is worth everything that it takes and ends up being the best that you can give. It's been a lot of fun and very exciting to see everybody give back to you, and I'm very nervous to give back to you. Everybody got prepared and worked hard. I'm doing it cold. And this number, normally an opening, well, count this whole show as your opening to your time of taking it easy. And though you're not going to be doing the 8-hour grind with the kids, just know that all the lives you touched, and you too, well, we still all have magic to do. Join us, leave your field to flower. Join us, leave your cheese to sour. Join us, come and waste an hour or two. Doodly-do, journey to a spot exciting, mystic and exotic. Journey through our anecdotic review. We've got magic to do just for you. We've got miracle plays to play. We've got parts to perform, hearts to warm, kings and things to take by storm as we go along our way. Intrigue, plots to bring disaster. Humor handled by a master. Romance, sex presented past for me. Diddly-dee, illusion, fantasy to study. Battles, barbarous and bloody. Join us, sit where everybody can see. We've got magic to do just for you. We've got miracle plays to play. We've got parts to perform, hearts to warm, kings and things to take by storm as we go along our way. Hey. Now I'm singing and acting now. It's been a while. Hearts to warm, kings and things to take by storm. As we go along, we've got magic to do. Magic to do, we've got magic to do for you. We've got foibles and fables to portray as we go along our way.
That ovation was for me, right? Well, this comes to an end. Arlene, we the students, would like to give your husband back to you. Thank you for the 30-year loan. We hope we're giving him back with interest. We hope also that tonight we've restored him at least a little bit to his former self. Ted, as you enter into the next act of your life, retirement, please remember that the legacy you left behind is alive and living in every one of us, and that we will continue to live for many years to come. We love you, Ted. We won't miss you. You'll be with us forever.
Hear it for the orchestra. God bless you. All the years. You know, I'm a wreck. I'm a wreck. I am 100% totally floored by all this. When we had the little concert choir banquet, and I thought it was very nice. And I had no idea I was coming to a karate demonstration. And I was very angry because, as always, we were late. And I was telling Arlie, now we're going to miss Carl's presentation for sure. And it's all your fault. I think I know who is responsible for this, but I don't want to say because I don't want to leave anyone out. Whoever it is, God bless you. You've made a high school, Ed Grogan. Of course, Jeff, I taught him everything he knows. I was just sitting down there and thinking how many high school choral directors can say that tonight was it 1,800 people at the Broadway Theater and 1,700 or 1,800 people at the Winter Garden Theater are seeing understudies because the stars of the show were here for their high school. But unfortunately, you've also learned my secret tonight. I'm not really that talented at all. I just have the most talented students that any high school choral director has ever had, and God bless every one of you. You've made my life so rich, and I leave wonderful memories. There's been a lot of magic on this stage, and you're responsible for it, and God bless you, and thank you for coming back. You've made me the most wonderful feeling person in the world. That's not a good sentence, is it? All right. So you've made me feel like just a million, and thank you so very, very much. And thank all of you for coming on this hot night. God bless you all. Thank you.